Cameron Wake, as you have had success in your 30s, I have wondered this. You leave Penn State, you go to the Giants for 6 weeks in the offseason, don't make the ball club, okay. And then you go to work as a mortgage banker,
yes,
as an intern at a fitness center, and eventually you became a personal trainer, right?
I did.
And so for 2 years, you're in the process before you go to Canada of doing that. As you have had great success into your 30s, how much has that personal trainer experience helped you to kind of keep your body fresh, learn new techniques? How much has that experience meant to your football success?
You know, it's helped me out in a lot of ways. Obviously, the physical part, it was a tremendous success, starting to get your body right, what to eat, what kind of exercises to do to get ready for, you know, the demands of the football world. But I think more so mentally, it was a tremendous success because it helped me kind of not only for time management, but that work ethic. You know, I was in the traditional 9-to-5 role where there's nobody helping you, there's nobody counting on you, there's no coach blowing the whistle, there's nobody waking you up. Those things are all on you. And obviously, to be successful in this profession, in this league, you got to be a self-starter, self-motivated. You know, you can't have people holding your hand or coddling you. And you know, those have been some of the lessons that I've tried to carry on, and you know, to my later years, and trying to also pass on to some of the younger guys as well.
Your story and the success has been unreal. I think a lot of us knew you as Derek Wake back when you were being recruited out of high school and at Penn State. And then you go to Canada and they get your name wrong and start calling you by your middle name, and suddenly you're Cameron Wake. What would Derek Wake think of Cameron Wake's great success in the CFL and now 10 years in the National Football League, 5 Pro Bowls, 98 sacks? Yeah. What would that guy back then have thought of what you have been able to do?
I hope he wouldn't be too surprised. I know it was a dream of his. You know, I'm thinking back to when I was a young pup and just, you know, wanting to be successful. I knew physically having the gifts and just, you know, wanting the opportunity. So Derek just wanted an opportunity. Just give me a chance. You know, once I get on the field, you know, I would like to think you wouldn't be able to deny me. And Cameron got the opportunity to do it. And I think Derek's cheering him on somewhere in the other world. But it's definitely been a tremendous journey. You know, I've loved every minute of it, all the ups and downs, everything that comes with it. And, you know, I'm looking for more. So I'm here.
So why didn't you correct the guy in Canada?
You know, at the time, I'll be honest, I didn't think I would stick. I didn't think I'd be there very long. I'm like, yeah, you know what? This might not be a big deal. But then obviously I started having success and I was like, well, it's not broke. So let's
are you
not
superstitious?
Fix it.
Is that?
I wouldn't say I'm superstitious, but it was something that was going well. So I'm like, I don't want to upset the apple cart. I'm just going to leave things as they are. And I kind of ran with it. And it's worked out for me so far.
What does your family call you?
Family calls me Derek.
They still call you Derek?
Yeah,
okay.
They call me Derek.
37 years old, you've made a couple of bucks, you've done well. Why keep doing this? Why is this still important to you?
You know what, every day I look in the mirror, and a goal of mine way back was to maximize your potential, you know, and I've always been a person that, you know, you wanna achieve more than you have in the past. Beat your best self, it's kind of like the mantra. And so, you know, every season, at the end of the season, I kind of look in the mirror and I say, hey, do you still have it in you? Can you still do more? And the answer is yes. You know, hey, coach, sign me up again. That day ever comes, that'll be the day I hang up the cleats and move on. But, you know, there's still a fight left. There's still, you know, I feel like ability to go out there and help teams win. And I still have a passion for the game. So, you know, all those things kind of fit together. My body's still, you know, in the right place. I still feel good. I'm not waking up moaning and groaning. And, you know, I still love the game of football. So that's what drives me. And that guy in the mirror keep telling me to keep going forward. So here I am.
Why the Titans for Cameron Wake?
The Titans organization has been one of the organizations that I have admired from afar. You know, actually as a younger guy, actually grew up watching the Freak as a youth, and the Tennessee Titans were a team that I really, you know, admired not only the, you know, organization, but, you know, the toughness of the teams and the way they played the game. So, you know, even we just obviously played you guys from Miami, the longest game in NFL history. Just being able to see the team, you knew they're going in the right direction and wanting to be a part of something that's obviously trending upward. So it seemed like a match made in heaven.
What does Cameron Wake have left to do?
You know what? I've done a lot of things, like you said, from the personal standpoint. You just mentioned some. I've gotten to the quarterback. I've been on Pro Bowls. I've been all pro contracts and all the things that are kind of, you know, subjective for me, for Cameron Wake. But I haven't been fortunate enough to kind of get any great team success. You know, to be standing holding trophies or you know, any kind of team accolades. You know, they've kind of slipped through my fingers. So that's kind of a big thing for me, is to go out there and make sure that, you know, it's not necessarily about me. It's about everyone going and achieving the next level, you know, whether it be division, champion, whatever it may be. Holding the trophy up and getting the ring is something that's really important to me.
Finally, Cameron, you're a preeminent pass rusher in this league. That makes you considered among your peers a great player. So when great players switch teams, you have that opportunity to impart that work ethic, the secrets, all of those sorts of things. As you work with a Kamalai Correa, a Harold Landry, a Sharif Finch, some of the really good young pass rushers on this team, what does it mean to you to come into this room and have that opportunity to pass along some of those secrets?
Well, that's always been something I've kind of held way at the top of my priority list. I was lucky enough when I came in to have players like Jason Taylor or Joey Porter, who were kind of like, you know, in the prime later years of their careers, they've gathered so many nuggets, so much wisdom playing this game over their, you know, storied careers. And they were guys who shared that wisdom. You know, they passed it on. They told me kind of all the little tricks of the trade, and you know, they've, you know, played certain teams 10 to 15 times and been able to say, hey, listen, this is what this offensive coordinator may be thinking about, or this is how you get to this quarterback. And you know, they shared that with me, and being able to do the same in return, not only is it something I think is important, but I feel like it's a responsibility, you know, to pass on that stuff. There's so many pieces of the game that you can only get from actually being on the field, hands-on experience. It's kind of like the saying where you don't diminish your own light by lighting another's. Like, you take one candle, light another, they both can shine. So I want everybody to be as successful as possible, because that only helps, you know, reach my ultimate goal, which is team success. So I want everybody to go out there and get the most sacks and the most Pro Bowls and the most accolades, because that's going to help, you know, the entirety of the team.